well, check this one out. Welcome back to the channel. You join me back on my syndicate lake down in Brighton, sea in Essex. Only been here about 20 minutes. Cast out to some showing fish. Essential IB popper, topped with a plastic cone. I've already had this little beauty. I'm here for 36 hours, so hopefully this is the first of many. Well, look at this one, another fish in quick succession. It's been about 25 minutes since I last had my first fish. This one was on the middle rod this time, Ronnie rig with essential cell popper. This is definitely going to be one for the future. This is probably the prettiest fish I've caught on this lake. Look at them scales, absolutely stunning. It was nailed right in the bottom lip, couldn't have asked for a better bite. Well, look at this beautiful creature. 28 pounds, took on the left rod. Went quiet for a couple of hours, so I put out some spawn mix, and some of that mix had corn on, and it's caught on the left rod, which had some plastic corn on, and I reckon that's what made this fall for the bait. Definitely one of my favourite fish. 28 pounds, bang on. Stick around and I'll show you what rigs and what baits I've been using to catch these fish in these tough conditions. On this session so far, I've had four fish, and three out of the four fish have been caught off of this rig. Now, it's simply just a basic hair rig. A lot of people are trying to overcomplicate things by trying different rigs, and then you're questioning whether it's your tactics or whether it's the rig that's not working. So I've just gone back to basics and just using a simple hair rig. It's 6 inches long from swivel to hook. And on this end, I've got a size 6 micro barbed wide gape hook with an essential cell bottom bait and an essential IB plastic cone over the top of it. It's high pressure, so I'm fishing in the margins and I'm spawning and throwing some bait into the margins where my rig's landing. And I reckon that's why I'm getting so much activity on this rod, is because it's simple and it matches my spawn mix. I'm not using anything different like bright pinks or bright oranges. I'm just using what is in my spawn mix. So I think that's why I'm having so much success on this one. And on my Ronnie rigs, I'm using two Ronnie rigs. Both of them are 7 inches long. One of them has got a size 6 Ronnie rig hook on it. But this one, I followed Mr. Fairbrass, and I've been using the size 6 long shank in micro barb as well. I just think it turns more aggressively, as you can see from one of the videos earlier on this video. It nailed it right in the bottom lip. It turns so aggressive, and I swear by this now. And on these rods, I am using my ever faithful mainline high impact high leakage pineapple wafters. I either use the wafters or the pop up, depending on the bottom. But I always use yellow, and this is by far my favorite bait. I've caught my PB on this bait, and I'll swear by it until the day I die. It is by far my favorite bait on the market. Nothing else compares to this. It's midday now. It's getting really hot. So I reckon the activity is going to die. So I'm going to spawn out put 10 spawns out on each rod, and then hopefully when bite time comes back around, there'll be more fish on the bank. One of the more common mistakes I see on the bank is when people actually hook into a fish, is they panic and they try and rush and try and get the fish in as fast as possible, but that's actually the wrong way to do it. What you should do is when you get a fish, just take your time, let the fish knacker itself out in the water, and then it's going to be less of a handful for you when it's on the bank.
I've just had a double run. One of them just took me into the snag over there. So the rod's just down on the rod stand. Hopefully that fish can become free while I fight this one. See, I'm just taking my time. I'm not in any rush to get this fish in. Just taking it nice and slow. The only time I would apply some pressure to the fish is if it was heading towards the snag like that one did. But that's became locked up now. I reckon I'm going to have to get the boat in to get that fish out. See some people on TikTok trying to fight and go absolutely mental fighting the fish when there's no need to. They're the type of anglers that will moan in 10, 20 years time and say, why have all the carp got knackered mouth? And it's because of people like that. Still just taking my time. I can feel it grating on something. I think it's caught on a branch underneath the snag to me right. That's another thing as well, if the fish is pulling, don't fight against it, just give it line. Let it tire itself out. As long as you keep that line tight and your hooks are in good condition, like they're sharp or new, then the hook shouldn't pull. It should be a nice easy fight. See it now. Not a monster, but still very welcome. How's this happen? I haven't even got my net near the water because it's not ready for the net, so I'm not going to try and convince myself that it's ready when it's not. When it's ready, it'll be floating up at the surface. Have it. That's how easy it can be, and it's the least amount of stress on the animal. And I'll leave it there for 5 minutes to calm down while I short this other fish out. Got me snagged around that little island in front of me.
And then we have fish number 5. This one was taken on the right rod that hasn't done nothing all day, but yeah, it's just screamed off. The fish I had in the snags unfortunately came off, so my double run turned into just one fish. But I've decided I'm going to set up base camp here for the night. That's producing a lot of fish. I've just put some more spawns out, so hopefully I can get some more on the bank. But for now, let's just enjoy this one we've got here. Look at this for the beauty. 27.5 pounds. Just had it on the middle rod. It's just wiped out all three of my rods though in the process. But when they look like this, I don't really care. Take me 5 minutes to set the rods back up, but this will live with me for a lifetime. Look at that. That is an absolute gorgeous fish. Light's against me now, so I'm going to get some spawns out and get the rods back out as quick as possible before night. But yeah, if I don't get one through the night, I'll catch up with you in the morning.
Well, good morning. Not much happened last night. I got woke up about 11 o'clock to a catfish. I didn't even know there was catfish in here, but I got woke up to a catfish. Unhooked that and put that back as fast as possible before anyone see. Then I woke up this morning, reset all three rods because it didn't have nothing last night, which is very strange on this lake. I reset all three rods and within half hour I had a screaming run. And the fish felt really, really heavy. That's probably the heaviest fish I've felt in this water. It just kept taking and taking and taking line, and it was heading straight for the snag. So I had to apply some pressure to the drag, and the hook come off. The rod got thrown on the floor. I was angry. I felt sick. I was so disappointed. But that's carp fishing, isn't it? I'll learn from that, and hopefully I'll hook into that again in the future. I've just reset all three rods now while it's bite time. Yeah, I'm waiting, so fingers crossed I can get another one on the bank.
Well, check out that little torpedo. Just fell victim to the essential IB bottom bait and plastic corn over the top and the snags. Definitely give up a little fight. They fight to the very end here. It's so frustrating sometimes. Even a fish this size can take 10-15 minutes to put in the nets. The water's deep at the edge of the swim. So they got room to dive down, so they just keep diving. It's just frustrating. But luckily we landed this one. It saves going home without a blank today. There's fish starting to show now. They're crashing all over my spot, so fingers crossed I can get a few more like this on the bank. Well, I just returned that fish back, went back fine. Give it a little bit of carp care. It had some damaged scales where it had come through the snags, but yeah, that's gone back fine. I want to talk about hook sharpness and maintaining your hooks. Now, down the years, I've learned, especially more so in the past 4 or 5 years, the hook sharpness is so important. This is the hook I've just caught that fish on then, and I'm rubbing it across my nail, and it doesn't really feel that sharp anymore. Rather than cut it off and put a new rig on, I got this little cheap hook sharpening set off of eBay. There's obviously bigger brands out there than this one, but I thought I'd take a little gamble with this one and see what it was like. Some of their stuff is crap, some of their stuff's all right, but yeah, it's got your files on there. It's got a little magnifying glass. It's got a little clamp so you can put your hooks on to sharpen it. And I think this cost me 14 quid off of eBay, and that is going to save me a lot of money in what it would to buy new hooks all the time. So after every fish, I always check the sharpness of the hook. It can be the difference between landing a fish and losing a fish, in my opinion. So it's always worth just checking it. Even if it takes 5 extra minutes to put the rod back out, it's worthwhile checking the hook, giving it a little sharpen to make sure it's as sharp as it possibly can be, and then get it out there and know that you're going to be fishing effectively.